Blabberize is a free web tool that you can easily use with students. You'll need to upload images to your desktop that you would like to blabberize or add voice to. The images can be pictures of characters from stories students have read, they can be images you've taken with a camera, or they can be images researched off the internet that are free for open source for students to reuse and modify. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and make one today. Create a free account, log in, and then click on the Make button, which will allow you to browse your desktop or your computer for an image. This is an image that I have actually chosen from the web, and I'm going to use that one. I'm going to click on the blue arrow, and it gives me a place to start drawing the mouth. Okay, so these little buttons will help you kind of cut out how you would like your animal, your creature to talk, or your image. And so you can kind of move the buttons around and move it around, maybe an opening of some kind. And you can see, there you go. You can kind of picture what it'll look like. That'll be the part that moves. Then you'll click on the blue arrow to go to the next page. And you'll choose your image, your audio source, and mine will be an internal microphone. But you can see you've got several options, including telephone, uploading an audio recording you've already made, or using a plug-in microphone or internal microphone. So I went ahead and clicked on microphone, and it's connecting, and then a record button will appear. When you finally connect it, and this took a while, that's why I paused it, this box will appear from Adobe, and you'll click Allow. And then you'll see your recording button. You can also see it recognizes your sound and picks it up and shows you what it'll look like when the kangaroo speaks. So here goes.
Hi, my name's Larry. In this story, I will travel all over my native continent, Australia. Do you know where Australia is located on a map?
It gives you a couple choices. You can edit or make another scene. I'm going to click save and tag it. So if you had a certain book, and you can make it private, you can make it public, whatever you want to do. I'm going to click save. I made it private because I didn't want anybody to see it because I was just making a sample. And that's how easy it is.